Hey guys, in this video, we're gonna look at the song Oh Pretty Woman by Roy Orbison. When I say look at the song, I mean to literally pick it apart to see how it was written. Not just to learn the chords to passively play along, but to actually get inside the songwriter's head, to get inside Roy Orbison's head, to see not only what chords he used, but also why he used these particular chords, and then a step further to understand how he arranged these chords into a pleasing chord progression. And we're gonna do this on both the piano and also on the guitar, so that you can see how these principles apply to either instrument to really build up your own songwriting skills. So to give you a snippet of what the song sounds like, it sounds like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Pretty woman, walking down the street. Like to meet pretty woman, I don't believe you, you're not the truth, no one could look as good as you. Pretty woman. Okay, so that's basically the chord progression. Well, there's a little bit more to it, and we're going to get into that first, starting on how these chords look on the piano. The song actually starts out with an arpeggiated chord, meaning a chord where not all the notes are played together, but in sequence, broken up, and it's an E major 7 chord. So E, G sharp, B, and D. So the pattern is 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, E, E, G sharp, B, D, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. F sharp, E, D, so it's E, E, G sharp, B, D, F sharp, E, D. So you repeat that 4 times, and then it goes into the verse section, which is A major. It starts with A major, that's an A, C sharp, and E with the right hand, and with the left hand, we reinforce that chord with 2 octaves of A. Pretty woman, walking down the street, and what that is we keep A and C sharp, and then just move E up to F sharp with the right hand, and then reinforce that F sharp minor with 2 octaves of F sharp with the left hand. So that's starting back at A. Pretty woman, walking down the street, pretty woman, back to A major, the kind I'd like to meet, back to F sharp minor, and then pretty woman. So we just go from A, F sharp, and C sharp up to D to play a D major chord, D, F sharp, and A, and then 2 octaves of D with the left hand. I don't believe you. So we shift up from D major up to E major, E, G sharp, and B with the right hand, 2 octaves of E with the left hand. You're not the truth. No one could be as good as. And then it's back into that riff, E major. And then we go back into the verse section of A major, F sharp minor, A major, F sharp minor, D major to E major. So that's the verse section. And then it goes into this really cool chord progression in the bridge where we're hanging on that E at the end of the verse. And then it goes into pretty woman. So that's D minor chord, which is D, F, and A with the right hand, and then 2 octaves of D with the left hand. Pretty woman, yeah, yeah, yeah. So what that is a G major 7 chord. So that's G, B, and D with an F. So G major 7 in second inversion. And then pretty woman. So C, E, and G is a C major chord, 2 octaves of C with the left hand. A minor. So it's an A minor in first inversion. A, C, and E, 2 octaves of A. And then back to D minor, G7, C major, and then we hit a C major 7 chord, so it's C, E, G, and B flat. And then in the bridge, we repeat that progression again. D minor to G7, C major to A minor, D minor to G7, to C. And then to shift back into A, we go A major, so from C major to A major, which is kind of an epic shift, to F sharp minor, to D major to E, A major to F sharp minor, to D major to E. And then once we hang on that E, it's a few measures of that arpeggiated E major 7 chord with the F sharp minor, F sharp E to D riff going on, and then back into the verse of A major and so on. On the guitar, this is how you play it. It starts with that E major chord, E7 chord really. So it's up on the 5th string, 7th fret, you have E, and then G sharp on the 4th string, 6th fret, and then up on the 9th fret, 4th string, you have the B, so it's E, G sharp, B, and then D on the 3rd string, 7th fret, so it's and then, so that's an F sharp on the 7th fret, 2nd string, and then E on the 9th fret, 3rd string, down to D on the 3rd string, 7th fret. So it's E, E, G sharp, B, D, F sharp, E, D, E, E, G sharp, B, D, F sharp, E, D. And then it goes into the verse of A major, so that's A, C sharp, and E, an open A chord, and then up to the F sharp minor, so that's barring the 2nd fret, and playing F sharp, A, and C sharp, back down to A major, to F sharp minor, and then to D, which is an open D chord, it's D, F sharp, and A, with an open 4th string, which is a D note, down to E major, which is an E, G sharp, B chord. So that's pretty woman walking down the street, pretty woman, the kind I'd like to meet, pretty woman, they don't believe you, you're not the truth. And then you go back to that riff of, and then back into the 2nd verse of A major, F sharp minor, A major, F sharp minor, D, E. And then we get into the bridge section. And this is where it goes to a D minor chord. So that's like the D major chord, but instead of F sharp, we play an F, so it's D, F, and A.
Pretty woman, yeah, yeah, yeah.
That is, that's a G7 chord, so it's G, B, and F. And we've got a D in there, so it's G, B, D, and then adding that F for that kind of tense 7th sound. So it's
pretty woman, yeah, yeah, yeah. Pretty woman.
So that's C, E, G, A minor, so A, A, C, and E. So it's D minor to G7 to C, and then we add that B flat note, which gives the C that 7th sound, 10th chord, and then it goes back into D minor to G7, C to A minor, D minor, G7 to C, and then la la la. So from C to A major, it shifts back into da 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 da. So that's F sharp minor to D. Minor, D to E, and then get back into the E, hanging on that E major chord. And then into the verse again of A, F sharp minor, and so on. So this chord progression is so catchy and really flows well. There's some real movement from the verse to the bridge, and that riff of the E major 7 chord sounds so good. But now that we know what chords to play, let's look a little deeper at why we're using these chords. And to do that, we're going to figure out what key these chords are in, and specifically what mode they're in. All right, so the song has 8 chords in total: A major, F sharp minor, D, E major, D minor, G7, C, also a C7, and then A minor. So it's one thing to know the chords, but we want to know what key they're in and what mode they're in. And the first question is, what key is it in? Now, most of the song resolves to A major, so the song is in the key of A. So to get our bearings, we're going to write the A major scale right here above the chords, above the modes, that is. And it's going to be A, B, C, sharp, D, E, F sharp, G sharp, A. That is the A major scale, and the scale degrees are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So to get our bearings, we have the A major scale, and we're going to place the chords within this table to see where the chords fall within the key of A. So A is the one chord. So we're going to put it right there. F sharp minor is in the sixth position, so we're going to put F sharp minor right here. D is in the fourth position, so we're going to put D right there. And then E is in the fifth position, so we're going to put that there. Now, before we get to this next layer of chords, let's start with these first four and see where they fall. And the first chord is A major, which is a major one. So the major one is in the Ionian mode, it's also in the Lydian mode, and in the Mixolydian mode. So far the song could have been written in any three of those modes. Then D major, major four chord, is in the Ionian mode, it's in the Dorian mode, and it's in the Mixolydian mode. So far, major one, major four are both in the Ionian and Mixolydian. So let's look at E major, major five, that's in the Ionian mode, it's also in the Lydian mode, and just those two. So it looks like this song was in A Ionian so far, because all three chords are in Ionian. But to confirm that, let's look at F sharp minor, which is the minor six, which is in Ionian. It's also in Lydian and Mixolydian. So really, so far, these chords are in the A Ionian mode, but we have some other chords. So now that we've placed those chords, let's make sense of these other four chords and what actually happens in the bridge section, because these are all the chords in the bridge section. The song actually shifts keys. It resolves to C. So in that case, C is actually the tonic in the bridge. And so let's write the key of C up here to understand what's going on there. We have C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C. That's the C major scale. And in the key of C, that scale degrees 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So C major, being the tonic of resolution in the bridge, is right here. It's a C chord. And then in the key of C, D minor is in the second position. So we're going to write it right there. And then G7 is in the 5 position. So we're going to put G7 right there. And then A minor is an A, so it's in the 6th position. So we're going to put it right there. So what we have here is C is a major one chord. So it could have been Ionian, it could have been Lydian or Mixolydian in the bridge section. D minor is a minor two. So in the bridge section, minor two is in Ionian. It's also in Mixolydian and Dorian. So it could have been so far Ionian or Mixolydian in the bridge. And then the bridge has a major five, which is in the Ionian mode and in the Lydian. And then A minor is a minor six in the Ionian, Lydian, and Mixolydian modes. So of those four chords, they all show up in the Ionian mode. So what we have here is the verse section is in the key of A Ionian, and then the bridge section is in the key of C Ionian. All right, so we've categorized all the different chords that are used in this song using the tonic, or the chord of resolution in each section, to get our bearings. And in the verse section, we have A Ionian. In the bridge section, we have C Ionian, so there's some modulation going on there. There's a key change. But what informs Roy Orbison's movement between all of these chords? It's one thing to know what chords he used, and then also to understand why he used these chords, what modes and keys they came from. The next question is, how did he arrange all of these chords as he did? What informed the movement that he chose? Part of it has to do with the way that the chords support and follow the melody. There's definitely an art to that, but there's also the science of chords, and the chords are guided by the theory of harmony. So to explain, let's start with the circle of fifths. This fundamental pattern illustrates how all notes and chords are connected to each other in music, which we can visualize with the color wheel. And when we focus on just these 12 notes and then rearrange them into the chromatic scale, which is the pattern of notes as they appear on instruments, unwinding them into a linear format like this, we can pick out the A Ionian mode. And by combining every other note in this pattern using tertian intervals, or intervals of major thirds and minor thirds, seven chords are formed, which make a string of harmonies that we can wrap into a loop of harmonic space like this, to then better understand how the song was written. These are the seven chords of the A Ionian mode, but looped within harmonic space. So we have the A major chord, major one, made from notes A, C sharp, and E. The minor three chord, C sharp minor, made from notes C sharp, E, and G sharp. E major, the major five chord, made from notes E, G sharp, and B, and so on. And while each of these chords is made up of three notes, we can really just refer to the root note, or the first note of each chord, as the chord itself. So in this case, A major can just be represented by this A major one, which can move to the D major chord, major four, D, to E major, the major five, and then back to A major one to move through harmonic space with a fluid motion. And in the intro section, it's really just hanging on this major five chord, the E major, and our arpeggiated E major seven. So it's made up from notes E, G, B, and D, moving between those notes to really just build up the tension before it goes into the verse section, which moves between A major, the major one, to F sharp minor, the minor six, back to A major, major one, F sharp minor, minor six, over to D major, the major four, passing through E major, the major five, back to A, and then looping through those chords a couple of times. And then in the bridge section, for some harmonic variety, the key changes from A major to C major, starting on the D minor chord, the minor two within the key of C, over to G major, the major five, which is actually a G7 chord. G, B, D, and F make a G7 chord, represented by the G here. And then over to C major, down to A minor, the minor sixth, back up to D minor, the minor two, to G7, the five chord, then to C, and then at the end of the bridge, it goes from A major to F sharp minor, the minor sixth, to D major, major four, to E major, major five, back to A, major one, F sharp minor, minor sixth, D to E, and then it hangs on that E again, the major five chord within the key of A, to really suspend the progression and make it want to resolve back to A, which it does in the last verse, to this progression once again. So the song definitely has some interesting harmonic movement, especially the modulation from the verse section in the key of A Ionian, then to the bridge with the C Ionian chords, and then back into A Ionian to get back into the next verse section. So it's a lot of chords, but it sounds amazing. So let's play all of these chords from beginning to end to really hear and see it all come together. So this is Roy Orbison's song, Oh Pretty Woman. I love this song. The lyrics can get a little awkward. If you imagine walking up to someone and singing, Oh Pretty Woman, Are You Lonely Just Like Me? You probably couldn't get away with that. It's probably not a good idea. In fact, it's not a good idea. But the song is amazing, and actually Paul McCartney said that he witnessed Roy Orbison actually writing the song at the back of a tour bus in 1964. The song was released in 1964, and McCartney described this as a magical experience, seeing it unfold before his eyes. The song is especially good, has such a great melody, and also the chord progression is amazing. That riff hanging on the E major chord, the dominant chord in the key of A, to really want you to get to that A, just really working the hell out of that dominant chord. And then also that key change to the bridge from A Ionian to C Ionian is such a nice move. This is such a great song. So thank you for watching this video. Let me know what you think in the comments, and I will see you in the next one.